Good morning. We have completed first unit vector analysis. The next unit is complex variables. Let us first have introduction of complex variables. The students who were having mathematics at 11th and 12th class are already familiar with complex variables. Let me give some short introduction of complex variables. You know various types of numbers, natural numbers, after that whole numbers, rational numbers. The mathematicians like Dedekind, Cantor and Weierstrass found that rational numbers are not sufficient for all mathematical needs, and therefore they extended the idea of rational numbers to real numbers. Real numbers consisting of rational as well as irrational numbers, and therefore now real numbers can provide us all mathematical needs for solving various problems, for performing various mathematical tasks in various subjects. While working with various mathematical tasks and problem, these people come across such equations. X square plus 1 is equal to 0. This is just one example. We can have many such equations, many such type of equations. These people found that X square plus 1 is equal to 0 has no solution in real numbers, because X square is equal to minus 1, X is equal to square root of minus 1. Square root of minus 1 is not a real number. It is not possible to find square root of a negative number. So, whenever the mathematicians and physicists come across such problems, they found that real numbers are not sufficient to provide all types of mathematical needs. Along with these people, these people were also working. Along with these people, Euler, Gauss, Cooper, Riemann, etc., were also working in various mathematical fields. These people also found that the problems like this could not provide solution by real numbers, and therefore all these people felt that the real numbers should be extended. Only real numbers are not sufficient to provide all mathematical needs, and therefore the idea of real number should be expanded, it should be extended to complex numbers. Complex number can provide solution to such mathematical problems, and therefore the idea of a real number is extended by these people to complex number, and complex number can provide solutions to various mathematical problems. Euler at the first time introduced I is equal to square root of minus 1, meaning that I is imaginary and value of this I is square root of minus 1. The physicist Gauss at the first time write a number of this type alpha plus I beta, and he called this number as complex number. Why this is known as complex number? In this complex number, alpha is real part, beta is imaginary part, I is there. Before beta, I is there. This I is given by square root of minus 1, which is imaginary. And therefore, real part plus imaginary part, that number will be a complex number. So, such complex numbers are used everywhere nowadays for various mathematical needs, to solve various mathematical problems. This is short idea about introduction of complex numbers. Let us move to the first article of this unit. That is, let us go for definition of complex number. Definition. Definition of complex number. An ordered pair of real variables. An ordered pair of real variables such as x, y is known as a complex number. An ordered pair of real variables such as x, y is known as a complex number. Such complex number is always represented by some English alphabet. Let us use here Z as the symbol for complex number, which can be written as x plus I y, or simply z is equal to x comma y. This is a complex number, this is also a complex number. What is x and y? X and y is an ordered pair of real variables. If an ordered pair of real variables is written this way or this way, that is z is equal to x comma y or z is equal to x plus iy, this number is known as a complex number, where x is a real part, y is also a real part, but I is here. As y is preceded by I, this y will be imaginary part. In this complex number, x is known as real part of the complex number, y is known as imaginary part of the complex number. And this x is written as rz or r of z or re of z. Y is written as iz or I of z or im of z. Real part x of a complex number can be represented this way. Imaginary part y of this complex number can be represented this way. Rz, z is complex number, r for real, real part of complex number z. What is meaning of rz? Real part of complex number z. R of z, real part of complex number z. Re for real, re of z, real part of complex number z. It means that x is real part of complex number z. Y, I z, I for imaginary, z for the complex number. I of z, I for imaginary, z for the complex number. I am of z, I am for imaginary, z for the complex number. So y is the imaginary part of the complex number. If we have two complex numbers, z is equal to x plus iy, and other complex number z dash is equal to x dash plus iy dash. Let us consider two complex numbers. First complex number, z is equal to x plus iy. Second complex number, z dash is equal to x dash plus I dash. Now, complex number z will be equal to z dash. Complex number z will be equal to z dash if and only if x is equal to x dash and y is equal to y dash. Complex number z is equal to complex number z dash if and only if x is equal to x dash and y is equal to y dash. When we work with complex numbers, we also work with the modulus of complex number, magnitude of complex number. If we have this complex number z, modulus of complex number z is written this way. If this is the complex number z, z is equal to x plus iy, then this is known as modulus of complex number z, and it is given by x square plus y square inside the square root. It means that modulus of complex number z is given by square root of x square plus y square, and modulus of z will be equal to 0 if and only if x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. If both x as well as y are 0, then only the modulus of complex number z can be 0. If x is not 0, y 0, z will not be 0. If y non-zero, x 0, z will not be 0. It means that to have z is equal to z dash, the required condition is x should be equal to x dash and y should be equal to y dash. Similarly, to have modulus of a complex number 0, x should be 0, y should be 0. If one of these two is not 0, modulus of a complex number will not be 0. This is about the definition of a complex number. This is in short about the introduction of complex numbers and definition of complex numbers. Next, we have to talk about the algebra of complex numbers. We shall start this in the next lecture. Thank you.